What's going on, good people? Glad you could join us for the next segment of the Indy Red Tails Black History Moment. My name is Dion Penix, and today's topic is about Harry T. Moore. And with that being said, let's get into it.
Harry Tyson Moore was born on November 18, 1905, in Houston, Florida, a tiny farming community in Sunawee County. He was the only child of Johnny and Rosa Moore. His father tended the water tanks for the Seaboard Airline Railroad and ran a small store in front of his house. Johnny started having health issues when Harry was 9 years old and died in 1914. In 1915, Rosa sent Harry to live with one of her sisters in Daytona Beach. The following year, he moved to Jacksonville, where he spent the next 3 years living with three other aunts. Jacksonville had a large and vibrant African-American community with the proud tradition of independence and intellectual achievement. Moore's aunts were educated, well-informed women. Two were educators and one was a nurse, who took this spinally intelligent boy into their house on Louisiana Street and treated him like the son they'd never had. Under their nurturing guidance, Moore's natural inquisitiveness and love of learning were reinforced. After 3 years in Jacksonville, he returned home to Suwanee County in 1919 and enrolled in the high school program of Florida Memorial College. Over the next 4 years, Moore excelled in his studies and he was even nicknamed Doc by his classmates. In May 1925, at age 19, he graduated from Florida Memorial College with a normal degree and accepted a teaching job in Cocoa, Florida, in the wiry wilderness of Brevard County. He spent the next 2 years teaching fourth grade at Cocoa's only black elementary school. During his first year in Brevard County, he met an attractive older woman, she was 23, while he was 20, named Harriet Vida Sims. She had taught school herself, but was currently selling insurance for the Atlanta Life Insurance Company. Within a year, they were married on Christmas Day, 1926. In 1934, soon after the birth of their daughters, the Moores founded the Brevard County chapter of the NAACP. Moore also helped organize the statewide NAACP organization. In July 1949, four black men were accused of raping a white woman in Groveland, Florida. Ernest Thomas fled the county and was killed by a posse. The other three were arrested and beaten while held in custody, forcing two to confess. In Groveland, a white mob of more than 400 demanded that the sheriff, Willis V. McCall, who had hidden the prisoners to protect them, hand the prisoners over for lynching. The mob left the jail and went on a rampage, burning buildings in the black district of town. McCall asked the governor to send in the National Guard, but 6 days were needed to restore order. The three young men, one only 16, were found guilty by an all-white jury. The judge sentenced 16-year-old Charles Greenlee to life in prison. Sam Shepard and Walter Irvin were sentenced to death. Executive director of the Florida NAACP, Harry T. Moore, organized a campaign against what he saw as the wrongful convictions of the three men. With NAACP support, appeals were pursued. In April 1951, a legal team headed by Thurgood Marshall won the appeal of Shepard and Irvin's convictions before the U.S. Supreme Court. While transporting Shepard and Irvin to the new trial venue in November 1951, Sheriff McCall claimed the two handcuffed men attacked him in an escape attempt. He shot them both, and Shepard died at the scene. Irvin survived his wounds. He later claimed to NAACP and the FBI officials that the sheriff shot both him and Shepard in cold blood. Harry T. Moore called for an indictment against Sheriff McCall and called on Florida Governor Fuller Warren to suspend McCall from office. 6 weeks later, on Christmas night, 1951, on the Moores' 25th wedding anniversary, a bomb went off beneath the couple's house in Mims, Florida. Both were fatally injured. Moore died on the way to the hospital in Sanford, Florida. His wife died from her injuries 9 days later at the hospital in Sanford. Harry T. Moore has been called the first martyr in the civil rights movement. He was the first NAACP official murdered in the civil rights struggle.
All right, that wraps up another segment of the Indy Red Tails Black History Moment. Hope you guys enjoyed it, and make sure you stay tuned for the next segment. And as always, applied knowledge is power. Thank you guys for watching.